There's a political candidate literally making commercials about killing Democrats and others. He has a long-term friend who has decided to actually do an intervention. Let me take you to Eric Greitens' commercial. Here it is.
I'm Eric Greitens, Navy SEAL, and today we're going rhino hunting. The rhino feeds on corruption and is marked by the stripes of cowardice. Join the MAGA crew, get a rhino hunting permit. There's no bagging limit, no tagging limit, and it doesn't expire until we save our country.
All right, this individual is running for political office again. Used to be a governor, had stepped down because of corruption.
We're back. And everybody remembers when we first rolled on the scene.
Well, I'm no career politician. I'm a Navy SEAL, and I'll take dead aim at politics as usual. Everyone also remembers that because I fought for you, they came after me. Well, we're back, wiser, stronger, still fighting, and this time with an army of patriots.
That was his second video that prompted his friend to do an intervention. Here's his friend.
Eric, I know you must be in a dark place to think what you're doing is worth it. I've known you for most of my life, from our first day at Duke to the time at Oxford. I remember your excitement coming back from the Democratic convention and what it meant to see America's first black president elected. I remember when you called to say you were running for governor. You had decided to do it as a Republican, but I figured a pro-choice, pro-gay marriage governor would be a win for Missouri. You asked me to donate $5,000. I didn't have it, but I took out a loan against my life insurance policy and mailed you a check. You asked if my mom, a lifelong Republican, could give as well. She did. Twice. Things have not gone as I expected. Eric, I want you to know that there are worse things in life than running for office honorably and losing. Trust me, I've done that. What you're doing now is not honorable, and it is not a reflection of the Eric I knew. Even if you do win, you're going to lose more than you can imagine by campaigning like this. You're called to hunt down Republicans who disagree with you? That's my mom, Eric. Just because she doesn't think the election was stolen, and let's be honest, you don't either, is not a reason to threaten her. Eric, what you're doing now is going to get someone killed. Do the right thing. Drop out. Focus on repairing the damage you have done. And pray it's not too late.
That's a real friend. His name is Ken Harbaugh. Mr. Harbaugh did this video to intervene, to provide context, clarity, maybe shake his friend back to a level of common sense. Mr. Harbaugh, your actions are honorable, sir. They will not work. Your friend is part of a cult. He has been programmed. He thinks that in order for him to obtain, retain, and maintain power, he must be connected to the cult energy. But I respect your attempt. This was tweeted. His friend said, Ken Harbaugh said, I have known Eric for 30 years. He is a broken man who would do anything, including inciting violence, to regain power. He's not the same person whose weddings I went to. Eric, drop out. Try to repair the damage you have done to your family, your country, and yourself. We need more people like Ken willing to call out their own friends in order to make this country a better place. Adrienne, thoughts?
I do think it's very admirable for that friend to make that plea, and I'm sure they tried privately, and so going public, I completely and totally understand it. You know, we do need more people like that who do care and show that they care about individuals who are sucked into this white supremacy propaganda mill. I do think that as a result of the rise with the Trump administration and everything else, and then the pandemic, a lot of people got sucked into it. I've had a family member who I've lost to it, and it's a very, very scary thing. And it's just a matter of other people using their voices to the best of their ability, but also we do have to put in the effort to shut down these propaganda mills, because we can't have individuals out here who do have certain clout and power in our society taking leadership positions when they've been indoctrinated with hate.
Well said.